So when the Ryzen 9000 series CPUs hit the market earlier this year, many big YouTubers like GamersNexus and Linus Tech Tips, they zeroed in on the gaming performance of these CPUs. But nobody seems to be talking about how these CPUs hold up in content creation workload. More importantly, how does Ryzen 9000 compare with the latest 14th gen Intel desktop CPUs when it comes to video editing in DaVinci Resolve Studio? Now, since Resolve happens to be my go-to editing software, I dove into the Puget Bench benchmarks to see which CPU truly delivers the goods for video editors. But before we dive into these results, I want to talk about how you can save some money. There is one way you can make your wallet happy. Cheap Windows 11 license key from our channel sponsor scdkey.com. SCDKey is a website where you can buy legit Windows 11 Pro keys for a fraction of the retail price. Microsoft sells Windows 11 license for $200, but if you use the 25% discount coupon code TP25, you can get Windows 11 Pro for only $23.46. Activating your copy of Windows is super easy. So press Windows button plus the S key and you will get this Windows search bar. Type activate and click on activation setting. Next, click on change product key and paste the Windows 11 Pro product key that you purchased from scdkey.com. Click next and voila, your Windows 11 Pro is now fully activated. So use the discount code TB25 when buying Windows license from scdkey.com. Your wallet will thank you and so will I, because when you buy keys from scdkey.com, you are financially supporting this channel. So thank you. So AMD recently announced its Ryzen 9000 series CPUs, and I think these CPUs are a modest refresh over the previous Ryzen 7000 lineup. They are still using the AM5 socket and they are fully compatible with the existing X670 motherboard, but the Ryzen 9000 is built on AMD's new Zen 5 architecture. And this upgrade does bring higher IPC, it brings better efficiency and enhanced memory support for an overall improved performance boost. But the million-dollar question for folks like me is, are any of these improvements helping video editing, especially when you are using something like DaVinci Resolve Studio? So I have pulled the latest Puget Bench scores for both Ryzen 9000 series CPUs as well as the 14th gen Intel CPUs. If you are interested in the detailed test bench setup, I would recommend that you go check out the Puget Bench article. I'm going to link it in the video description below. So let's start with the long GOP codecs. I'm talking about compressed codecs like H.264 and HEVC. Most consumer cameras, whether it's from Sony or Canon, they use these codecs. So in this benchmark, clearly Intel is winning. So the Core i5, Core i9 and Core i7, they are all on the top. And as you can see, interestingly, the Core i5 CPU seems to be performing the best. And I have put the latest price of these CPUs. So the Intel Core i5 14600K is going for only $290. And it's sitting right at the top of this chart. Now, if you're wondering why Core i9 and Core i7 are behind, I mean, these are very close. And my guess is that with more cores, you may have slightly lower single core performance, and that might be playing some role, but this is all very close and it doesn't really matter. So I would say that if you are mostly dealing with H.264 or H.265 codec, even a cheap processor like Core i5 will do pretty good. Unfortunately, the AMD processors are all way behind. Look at the Ryzen 9 9950X. This guy is $624 at the time of making this video, and it's actually falling behind all these three guys, right? Even Core i5 is beating it, so that's not very good. So for folks who are using Sony or Canon cameras and plan to just shoot in H.264 or HEVC codec, I think you are still better off going with Intel. Now, by the way, guys, you probably already know about the heating issues with the Intel CPUs. I'm on a 13th gen Intel Core i9 CPU and I had seen some problems, but ever since I upgraded to the latest BIOS on my Asus motherboard, everything has been running fine. Now, that is something that a lot of folks are worried about, and if that is the case, then maybe you can just completely ignore Intel and go with AMD. But at least based on what I have personally experienced and what I have seen other people mention after they upgraded the firmware and the BIOS on their system, the 14th gen Intel CPUs now seem to be quite stable. Next, let's talk about the intra-frame codec. So more advanced cameras, cine cameras, for example, they use all intra compression. Now, this compression is actually not as tightly compressed as H.264 or H.265. So these codecs are actually better on your system. So you will have an easy time editing videos if you're shooting in all intra compression codec. So here the $550 Core i9 14900K is the champion. The remaining three CPUs are the AMD CPUs, but if you look at the price, you can get the Core i9 for $550, whereas the Ryzen 9 9950X is for $624. This is the latest price that I checked here in the United States. So based on these pricing, again, Intel is coming out on the top. And of course, if you are worried about the Intel, the stability issue, then I really can't help you. If that thing is bothering you, then maybe just stay with AMD. But if you are coming with an open mind, then I think the Intel Core i9 for the intra-frame compression, if you are using a Cine camera, I think you are still better off getting an Intel Core i9 processor. Now the Core i7, which is 372, and the Core i5, which is 289, these two guys are actually not doing so well for this compression. So I suppose if you have a Cine camera, either go with the Core i9 or go with the AMD processors. Next up, let's look at the RAW codec. So this is the Blackmagic RAW, as well as if you are using some other kind of RAW format, like the Red RAW format, then here it's very interesting. AMD is actually performing better than Intel. So the $624 Ryzen 9 is actually at the top, followed by Ryzen 9900X. So these two guys are at the top. The Core i9 is at the third position. Now, if you look at the price, $550 makes it more expensive than 9900X, but cheaper than 9950X. So it's kind of sitting in middle of these two processors. So the bottom four, you have alternating AMD and Intel. Ryzen 7 is at fourth position, followed by Intel, again followed by Ryzen, and again followed by Intel. So the bottom line is, if you are dealing with Blackmagic RAW or if you are dealing with Red RAW, then I suppose AMD is going to be a better choice for you. Next, let's talk about Fusion. So this is all the fancy things that you can do in DaVinci Resolve. I am not a Fusion expert. I do some basic Fusion effects, and a lot of these effects will run on your GPU, but a lot of stuff actually happens on the CPU. So it's not all your GPU. And out here again, Intel Core i9 is at the top. And interestingly, the Ryzen 7 is at second position. The more expensive Ryzen 9 is it's second to last here. So not sure what happened here. If I have to make a guess, it may be that the less number of cores, sometimes they actually benefit, because you can boost the single core performance. You can extract better performance if you have less cores, because you can actually crank them up, you can push them harder. But that's just my guess, or this could just be a test bench setup issue also. I'm not sure what's happening here, because this does not make sense why $624 chip is at the bottom. Seems like if you are a heavy Fusion user, obviously you need a good GPU, so go get something like RTX 4090 and maybe pair it with an Intel Core i9, 14th gen Intel Core i9. And finally, let's look at the overall score. This is the sum total of all the effects on DaVinci Resolve. So Puget Bench gives a final score. And in this benchmark, the Intel Core i9 comes out at top. The next three positions are taken by the AMD CPU. The Ryzen 9 9950X, the most expensive CPU here, is at the second position. Now, Intel Core i5 is right at the bottom here. And the Intel Core i7 is at the fifth spot. So the bottom line is that the Intel Core i9, the $550 CPU, is the champ here. This is going to give you the best bang for your bucks. Now, if you don't want to buy an Intel CPU because you are just wary of the 14th gen Intel CPUs because of all the issues that have happened in the past, and you don't want to take a chance, then your next best option is the Ryzen 9 9950X. But like I showed you in some of the H.264 and H.265 compression codecs, this CPU was not really doing such a good job. So I want to reiterate, this is the long GOP score. This is the H.264 and HEVC compression, and you can see that the Intel CPUs are doing the best here. And the $624 CPU, your Ryzen 9 9950X, is at the fourth position. So this is a mixed bag here, and if you are an AMD fanboy, you may not like these results, but the bottom line is that the 14th gen Intel Core i9 gives you the best bang for bucks if you are using DaVinci Resolve Studio. So I will crown the Intel Core i9-14900K as the champion, and your runner-up is the $624 Ryzen 9 9950X. I honestly think that this, the price needs to come down. If Intel is selling their flagship chip for $550, I think AMD needs to drop the price. They should drop about $75 on this chip and sell it for around $550. Because at this price, I have my doubts. Like, we already have seen Linus Tech Tips and, Gamers Nexus. They have shown us that the gaming performance is not that good. If you are a gamer, maybe you should wait for the X3D chips. But if you are a content creator, then maybe you should skip AMD and go with Intel. Now, I understand the problem a lot of people have with the Raptor Lake CPUs because of all the problems, right? All the issues that we have been hearing for the last 1 year. But remember, Intel has increased the warranty on these CPUs. So now Intel is giving 2 more years of warranty. So if you buy one of the Raptor Lake CPUs, I think you will be covered for 5 years. So even if your CPU craps out in 2-3 years, you can get a new one from Intel. So to me, that doesn't sound so bad. Now, of course, if you don't want to have anything to do with Intel, go with AMD. But I would say maybe wait for some time because I expect the prices to drop. $624 for the Ryzen 9 9950X, to me, that sounds too much. Now, if you're wondering what is the best GPU that you can pair with these CPUs to get the best video editing performance, then check this video over here and I will see you guys in that video. Bye.